And welcome to the Stan Watson Show. I am the co-host, Samantha Cardwell, and I am here with a guest co-host, Miss Bea W. Bliss. Welcome, Bea.
Hello, how are you?
I'm doing well. Glad to have you on the show tonight.
Awesome to be here.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Did you have a great day today?
I had a beautiful day
today. Awesome. It was a pretty day here in Atlanta, and excited about tonight's show. We have an awesome lineup, a window seat into our community activities, and definitely we want you to stay right here with us, so don't touch that dial. We'll be right back after the break, right here on The Stan Watson Show. And we are back here on the Stan Watson Show, and I'm excited about our first guest. It makes me want to get out my hiking boots and put on a backpack and really rough that weather. We're going to hit the mountains, and we've got guests with us, Mira Cardenas, Executive Director of the Arabia Mountain Heritage Area Alliance, Inc. Man, that's a mouthful.
Yes, it is.
Well, so tell us what you guys do there. It sounds like a lot of outdoor activity.
There's a lot of outdoor activity, but a lot of activities surrounding history and culture and nature.
Okay.
So the Arabia Mountain Heritage Area Alliance is a nonprofit,
okay. And
I lead that nonprofit. Our nonprofit is comprised of partner organizations and people who are connecting the community to history and nature and culture that is within the Arabia Mountain National Heritage Area.
Wow, and now the Arabia Mountains, I know for those that don't know, you've got to tell us where that's located.
Right. So Arabia Mountain itself is a DeKalb County park.
Wow.
And it's located in Lithonia, just south of I-20,
okay.
Along between the South River and I-20.
Wow.
So you have Arabia Mountain, which is this beautiful granite outcrop, or a fun word, new word for the day, monadnock. So it's very similar to Stone Mountain, but the Arabia Mountain National Heritage Area is really much bigger than just the DeKalb County Park. It also includes Panola Mountain State Park,
okay.
So we have two monadnocks,
okay.
And the Monastery of the Holy Spirit,
okay.
The Flat Rock Archives, the city of Lithonia, and linking this all together is a 30-mile Arabia Mountain Path, which is a hiking, biking, paved, dedicated bike trail with multiple opportunities for people to get out and enjoy nature.
Wow. Well, now, it sounds like a lot of history, because I heard you talk about lots of different areas, and I suppose that each piece of it sort of has its own kind of background, a lot of history.
Yes, very much, but it's all very connected too. It's
okay.
Connected by a history. I think we all can identify a history of struggling to survive,
mm-hmm.
But also a history of nature. If you, our slogan, see 400 million years from here, is because that's how old Arabia Mountain is. So it's, so we're talking about history as it's tied to ecology, but also history as it's tied to people who worked the land,
mm-hmm.
to people who live there, to people who settled the area. For example, in the case of the Flat Rock Archives, this is an African-American community that was established actually during slavery. It was the families who worked on three surrounding plantations. But after emancipation, they stayed in the area, and the Flat Rock Archives tells the story of how they survived and thrived through Reconstruction,
okay.
through Jim Crow,
okay.
through the Great Migration, and why this particular community stayed here in Georgia. So it's a wonderful story and not something that you necessarily tie with a nature area,
right.
But they're all linked together. And the 30-mile bike trail helps to link those stories together. So it's not something that you can actually see when you're out on this bike trail, how these stories fit together and enjoy the beauty and the scenery that does link them.
Now, are there tour guides or these guided tours where if I were to go and bring my family, for example, there's someone who can kind of tell me this as I go along so my kids kind of understand what's going on? Are there booklets or pamphlets that you have that kind of guide folks that maybe they're visiting? How does it work?
Right.
Because I hear you, but I get over there and I go, and there's this, you know, this thing in the path.
And there's that. There are several different ways that it works, and it depends on the different venue. So, for example, at Arabia Mountain, the DeKalb County Park, you can take a hike with Ranger Robbie on Friday mornings or Sunday mornings, and he can take you around the park.
Okay.
At the Monastery of the Holy Spirit, there's a visitor center, exhibits that talk about spiritualism and monasticism throughout the ages, but also talk about why these monks chose this rural community in Georgia to settle in.
Okay.
And then you have Panola Mountain State Park that has some fantastic activities such as archery classes.
Okay.
They do guided hikes of the mountain. Arabia Mountain you can hike at any point. Panola Mountain you need to go up with a guide. It is a national natural landmark,
mm-hmm.
and it is a conservation area, so it's protected from all of our feet that damage the very tiny plants that are there on Panola Mountain. So Panola, you can take an archery class, you can rent kayaks, you can rent bikes there, you can spend the night in a tree if you want. So you're really only limited by how much time and energy you have that day. So there are different activities, there are different ways to engage with the area. You can throw your bike in the back seat of your car and drive to any one of these places and get on the bike trail immediately. So the area is accessible, open to all. There are not at Panola Mountain State Park, there's a parking fee, but if you happen to go to your local library, you can actually get a pass for the day to go to any state park.
Okay.
So
now, is it open to all ages?
Oh, yes.
All ages.
Yes.
Okay.
All ages and really all ability levels as well. So I'm going to direct you all to our website, which has links to all of our partners. It also has different programs that we have available, and very key, it has maps available. So we have a very detailed map of the bike trail. We have a very detailed map of the heritage area itself, because it is a very large area. It's 65 mm-hmm. square miles, over 40,000 mm-hmm. acres. But we are one of the smallest national heritage areas in the country. We are affiliated with the National Park Service. There are only, Augusta Canal is the only other heritage area within the state of Georgia. And what we do all together are preserve, protect, and promote history and culture and nature. And one of the ways we do that at Arabia Mountain is through connecting people on this bike path to their history, to their culture, and to the unparalleled nature that is at Arabia and Panola.
And so when you use that term, National Heritage Area, because
yes.
I want to put a little placeholder there.
Oh, yes,
as
definitely.
To what that means.
Yes.
What you're saying is that you recognize that you are connecting people to their
yes.
heritage, and that
yes.
so that's why you're kind of given that label. Is
yes.
that right?
Well, it's a designation.
Okay.
And it actually takes an act of Congress.
Okay.
And I think we all know how difficult that can be to get an act of Congress passed. That it takes an act of Congress to become a national heritage area. And then once you do become a national heritage area, then you work with the National Park Service. So we are a partnership program of the National Park Service.
Okay.
So essentially, here in DeKalb County, you have a national park in your backyard.
That's great.
And it's a phenomenal resource to take advantage of. And to take advantage of, you know, through hiking, through biking, when I mentioned the other ability levels on the bike trail, it is handicapped accessible as well.
Awesome.
So you can take a wheelchair out on the bike trail. And it's not so aggressive that that you should feel, that anybody at any ability level should feel uncomfortable going out there. It's a very supportive environment to, if you're just going out to walk a mile, or you just got a brand new bike, or you want to teach the kids how to bike.
Sure.
It's a great place to go. I'm going to warn you though, this is not this is not flat and straight.
Sure.
It's an exceptionally constructed bike trail that was built over the past 12 years by the PATH Foundation, who's done phenomenal projects all around Atlanta, including they're working on the Beltline now, but including the Silver Comet Trail and the trail that goes out to Stone Mountain. Mm-hmm. So they built this trail to specifically link the historic, cultural, and natural sites within the National Heritage Area, and it's curvy and it's hilly, and it is a lot of fun. Beautiful vistas. You'll come around a corner and you'll just see a historic farm in a field. And today, especially living in Metro Atlanta, that's not something
that
you see. And it really it takes your breath away, and you really feel a connection to the people who live there, and a connection to that beauty that has been preserved through the actions of the Arabian Mountain Heritage Area Alliance.
And you mentioned, I'm sorry, did I?
Well, I was just going to ask, what are the hours? Is it open 7 days a week?
It's pretty much dawn to dusk, 7 days a week, 365.
Oh,
so some places that do have hours. So, for example, the Flat Rock Archive is not open 7 days a week. But Arabia Mountain, it's a DeKalb County Park, dusk to dawn, 365.
Wow.
There's no parking fee. It is accessible and open to the public. By checking our website, arabiaalliance.org,
okay.
ArabiaAllianceorg. There's a double A in there, and that throws people off sometimes. So arabiaalliance.org, maps, hours, links. You can also sign up for our newsletter, which will tell you about special events that we have coming up, and different things. The mountain itself, Arabia Mountain and Panola Mountain, both of the granite monadnocks, change so much during the year. Mm-hmm. Even if somebody has said, oh, but I've been there before. Mm-hmm. In the spring, it's covered with this carpet of brilliant red flowers. And then in the fall, we get the bright yellow Stone Mountain daisies.
Wow.
So I'm going to start calling them Arabia Mountain daisies, because they're
yeah.
But they only bloom within 60 miles of Stone Mountain. And so in a couple weeks, the mountain will just be covered with these glorious yellow daisies.
Wow, and I suppose even as a creative, if you're a photographer, I mean, that's the best, you know, backdrop, and best natural backdrop.
Yes, nature helps your photography a lot.
Yeah.
Out there, it gives you brilliant colors, the play of light during the day, and if you just think, it's just a rock. No, it's beautiful. And the rock itself is teeming with life. It's a little micro, there are puddles on the rock. Vernal pools that are their own ecosystem in themselves.
Sure. Mm-hmm.
And by taking one of Ranger Robbie's tours, he can teach you a little bit more about what is living in this small little pool.
Wow. Well, and now you mentioned something akin to like classes that you have, or activities that you have. Talk a little bit more about that, the other activities.
Right.
There's sort of the self-guided stuff that you do.
But right.
There are some things that you do that you are actually putting on for the public to join.
Yes. Ranger Robbie, DeKalb County Parks and Recreation, hosts the guided ranger tours twice a week. Panola Mountain State Park. I'm going to actually check my notes here, because
okay.
we have a lot of
cheat,
great events coming up. As I mentioned, just in the next couple weeks, there are archery classes at Panola Mountain State Park. Classes about learning how to climb the tree, and you won't spend the night in the tree, but you'll learn how to. Now, this is not tree climbing where you're thinking like you're a little kid and you're just running out in the backyard climbing a tree. There are ropes and pulleys, and it's very sophisticated, and the trees themselves have to be certified
to hold
everybody. Yeah, because you do it in a big group. We have a wonderful program coming up in conjunction with the Audubon Society on identifying butterflies in your backyard. Okay. Arabia, Panola, and the Monastery of the Holy Spirit are all phenomenal ecosystems for butterflies. So learning how to identify them and spot them, and then you go out and actually go on a walk and start to find them. We also have a woman safety seminar coming up on September 26th that just talks about how to be safe on the trail and how to enjoy the outdoors while also being safe. Your State Parks Day is on September 27th, so Panola Mountain State Park is hosting a native grasses restoration project. So an opportunity to volunteer, of which there are many out there as well. The Monastery of the Holy Spirit is having their fall festival on October 4th, and they really put on a great show and have petting zoos and all that for the kids and lots of fun activities, in addition to having a health fair there at the end of the trailhead. And then we have a really special event that I'd like to tell you all about. I've mentioned the word Monadnock a couple times, which essentially is the type of mountain that Arabia Mountain and Panola Mountain and Stone Mountain are. Okay. So during the month of March, instead of March Madness, we have Monadnock Madness.
Okay.
And it's a program where you hike all three mountains in one day.
Wow.
And you get a special souvenir at the end,
yeah,
because after that you deserve it. But it's a great way to see how these mountains are linked together.
Okay.
To get outside. It's a fabulous family activity. It's and you see even people who've been there before. I think I mentioned with Arabia Mountain and the different flowers and the fauna. And it also gives you a chance to see Stone Mountain in a different way without the amusement park and the sky lift. You know, you're seeing it in a way
in
where you're looking at the
way.
in its natural state. Yes.
Well, man, that is a lot of information.
Yes. So ArabiaAlliance.org will help you out.
Definitely. Well, you know, thank you for all that you've shared with us on today,
you.
And I'm sure there's much more than that.
Do we have a quick second for me
to? We have a quick second.
All right. Well, in here, I'm going to reach behind. I brought you all a hiking survival kit.
Okay.
So in here, we have some maps for you all. You know, when you're out on the trail, you want to make sure that you stay hydrated.
Sure.
So you have an Arabia Mountain mug with you.
Okay.
Might want to get a water bottle,
right,
too. One of our Monadnock Madness souvenirs, highly coveted. So this is like all the hikers wear the kerchiefs around their necks. A couple other things in here, including a little first aid kit in case you're not used to walking all those miles, and you get a few toes. We do have in here a few maps for you all for your hiking adventure, and then one of our flashers that goes on your bike or your backpack so that people can see you when you're out there.
Yeah.
So hopefully this will get you started.
Just to get out there.
And for those who don't have the hiking survival kit, ArabiaAlliance.org will leave them.
That
so there you go. There's
awesome.
A hiking for two
amazing.
In the packet.
Amazing. Well, we have had, this has been a chock full of information. We've had you, Mira Cardenas,
yes,
the executive director, and definitely you've already given us enough information. At least we could get started, right?
Yes. Yes, and we hope to see you. And please share your experiences with us on Facebook and on Twitter.
Definitely we will, and we'll send folks to the website, which is www.Arabia Alliance, and remember that double A in there, ArabiaAlliance.org. This has been awesome. It's been very interesting. We are going to take a break, and we'll be right back with more great guests right here on the Stan Watson Show.
Thank you.
And welcome back. The Stan Watson Show is right here on your television, and we're excited because we've had some awesome guests, but we also have more lined up. I have with me my co-host on tonight. It's Bea W. Bliss, and we are excited because we have with us the group Our Seeds Tomorrow. We have with us Dazia Fumba, and he is the executive director of that group. He's brought some additional guests with him, and that's Dion Wright and Marlon Campbell and Dr. Johnetta McSwain. Welcome, everyone. Welcome.
Thanks for having us.
We're so glad to have you this evening.
Thank you so much.
Great, great, great. Well, I know you have an awesome, amazing story to tell. It starts with the country of Liberia, and I want you to tell everyone why you're here with us on this evening.
Basically, I'm here today, born in the Republic of Liberia, had an opportunity to come to the United States in 2005 and attend Columbia High School. So my start was in DeKalb County,
awesome.
Where I graduated from school and has always been in DeKalb County. And DeKalb County offered my first job at the park on my Golden High School.
Okay.
You know, the park
okay.
across the street.
Yes, 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 yes.
So I had a job and had an opportunity to make $99 a week.
Wow.
And that
big
was
money.
Such a big money coming out of Liberia.
Money.
And I called all my friends home. I'm making $99. And said, no, we can't believe it. Send us stuff.
Yes.
And as a kid, you know, that was huge. Yeah.
Awesome, awesome. Well, you know, of course, we're happy to have you in DeKalb County. And since then, you have been contributing to DeKalb County in so many ways. Your organization, Our Seeds Tomorrow, also gives back to the Republic of Liberia with the recent outbreak of the Ebola virus. You're making people aware of that in so many ways. And so tell us more about how we can now pour back to you.
Thanks so much. Just want to let the world know, the international community, Friends of Liberia. The issue that we have in Liberia today, it is a world issue. It is a world crisis. We have Ebola in the region of West Africa, again in Liberia. And Our Seeds Tomorrow is working to empower nurses, healthcare workers, the feeding program of the people within the quarantine provision, people that are isolated and kind of lacking food. And the purpose is to definitely help with resources
sure.
like chlorine, like mm-hmm. water, like bed, like food, like protective gear, gloves,
sure.
because we having people lost in their lives senselessly mm-hmm. to a virus that Emory University, that I worked a couple years ago, has proven that this virus can be controlled.
Sure.
And we can do a lot. So that is the focus of Our Seeds Tomorrow, being involved within the logistics of the region. And saving lives by saving lives. When I use the word saving lives by saving lives, if we save life in Liberia and control the Ebola crisis epidemic, we can prevent the Ebola from coming across to United States and other countries, because it's a fear factor that we are dealing with.
Sure. Sure. And a lot of times fear comes from misunderstanding,
yes,
not being educated about a thing or a concept. So what is it that your organization does to educate folks about either the disease or even just access to the things that you described?
Part of the piece, I know you just realized, we did the Ebola panel discussion.
Mm-hmm.
And we wanted to bring that awareness piece to a lot of people. Don't get the misconception, don't get the misinformation of the street.
Sure.
We brought in Dr. Gopi from Emory University, who has a PhD also. His work was directly, this incident was definitely on Ebola.
Mm-hmm.
And he did a huge piece that we invited a lot of people. So we brought people in and gave them the facts on Ebola. And because when people don't know, if you go to the street and what you hear today about
yeah.
Ebola, it scares you.
Right.
And a lot of people is not getting the right information. So one of the key things that we started to do was to educate our American counterparts, and also we are also collaborating with some of the healthcare workers that are also educating the people of Liberia, Sierra Leone, and Guinea
mm-hmm.
to be able to have some of the resources that we are asking for donation to be able to move this logistics to help these people that are working in Liberia. And also we are trying to build a unit command center here that we can have volunteer work with us as well.
Awesome. The other thing that I see that you're doing is there is a sense of teamwork. So, for example, you have members here from other organizations and groups that are represented that are saying, you know, how can we help? How can we pull together so that we have a unified front to fight not just against Ebola, but yes. to fight against some of these other misconceptions yes. and things like that so that we can dig in our heels because, you know, together as a community, we're stronger. So I'd like to hear from some of the other members. Are these members of your panel? Explain how these other groups are helping assist you with getting this message out.
Yeah, we have Dr. Dan in the middle up here on the far right. she has come much more on within the health awareness education, okay. media education, very smart. She has a master's degree in public health education. And we also have Dr. On the far right, and she also is a person from down in the Garda who has okay. come a long way and also earned her PhD, and she do a lot of speech around mm-hmm. the world, traveling, empowering women education, women movement, domestic violence, and all of the other piece you can think about. We have Mr. Martin Campbell, a film producer, who is also on the advisory board awesome. On the media piece, as well as Dr. Deanne, also on the advisory board of our Seas Tomorrow, and all of this group with a lot of other people, if you look at the organizations that is involved, if you look at our board members and directory, that has come together as a team, because together we can succeed. Mr. Dazia just can't do this by himself. I may be the vision bearer, but at the same time, there are other people that can come to impact this vision and make difference with life across the globe.
Absolutely. Now, do you have events or things that we need to be aware of that are upcoming that give us the opportunity, us, and when I say us, I'm talking about the viewers, I'm
yes,
talking
ma'am.
About Stan and those who are in maybe the political ranks that can now become stakeholders in the vision.
Yes, ma'am. I'd like to extend appreciation to DeKalb County CEO Stan, all the other commissions and all the directors. I want to also inform you, the event we have on July 26th, the county were very supportive. They brought in a television crew, and I was very excited to get
awesome.
Free TV time.
Yeah.
So they came true, and they were on site for about 2.5-3 hours.
Wow.
I mean, yes, supported us a long time. And the program very successful because we prepared the kids to go back to school. That program was supported by Walmart Foundation, SAM, or Atlanta Braves.
Okay.
We had some great things happen that day. For the kids, Walmart donated like 1,000 hamburgers, hot dogs, water, everything,
yeah.
thousand. So all the kids were happy to have backpacks, we prepared them. And then we also did a health awareness and peace for the kids,
yes.
the preparation of going back to school. Mm-hmm. So that event was very successful. We moved into the Ebola event that happened last Thursday. That's another health education piece that we did. And another big piece that is coming up is called Women Rise.
Mm-hmm.
Women Rise is an event. When I was growing up as a young boy, my mother always said to me, son, if you educate a man, you educate an individual. I said, Mama, what do you mean if you educate a man? May her soul rest in peace. My mom, Lavesta Dennis Jones. If you educate a man, you educate an individual. She said, well, you educate a woman. And she said it with that voice, you can hear it. You educate the nation.
Wow.
So, and there is facts to that. And I can tell you why. When you look at our mothers and sisters in the home, they are always educating the men.
Sure.
You wash the dishes, do this, wash the car. It's all of the time, the more the family. They are responsible being the mother creation mm-hmm. of the earth. They give us guidance, and some people don't like to say, but as a man, I'm a mama's boy, and I will always admit the truth.
He said that on national television as well. So that you all heard it. I'm sorry.
I told him with you on that.
Yes.
I told him with you on that.
Mom. Yes.
It's totally okay.
Yes. Okay.
We talked about that, right?
Yes.
It's okay to be a mom.
There is
boy.
No issue with that whatsoever.
Yeah.
But well, so, and then you also mentioned that your mother actually was an inspiration for
yes.
this vision.
Yes.
And so, rightfully so,
yes.
that the event, Women's Women's Rise,
yes,
would be upcoming here October the 18th.
Yes, we pushed that last weekend in October.
Okay,
yes.
Last weekend in October.
That's Saturday.
What can we expect at that event?
And I would like some of the other stakeholders and board members to talk about that a little bit more. Dr. Dan, can you cover that a little bit more?
Sure.
For that conference, we'll be looking at women's health issues.
Okay.
We'll be focusing also on domestic violence and relationships. And also on finance, in addition to just job readiness, because to Dazia's point, it's very important for women to, as I'll speak for myself, as a mother and as a wife, I tend to lead the direction of my home. I force my husband to go to the doctor. I make all the doctor's appointments. So it's a very good cause. And to Dazia's point, it's very important for women to really, really step up and also recognize what resources are out there in order to help them to help their families.
Sure. And now you'll be working, or all men and women alike will be working in this conference together. It's not just a women's conference.
We all are operating under the umbrella of Our Seats Tomorrow.
Awesome.
And so we support all initiatives.
Yes.
And
there's
no
good.
Everybody can contribute. As you see, we have a very diverse set of people here. And when we put our heads together, I mean, it's amazing what comes out. So we're all supportive of each other.
Awesome.
I just want to add on the Women Rise that we're going to be looking at the domestic violence. That's a very strong piece that I'm here for. I'm an expert in domestic violence and child sexual abuse, as myself was a victim of domestic violence and sexual abuse. And just today, we've been hearing about the Ray Rice story and punching the wife in the face in the elevator. So it just lets you know what we're dealing with here, right here in our own community. There's a lot of domestic violence. Atlanta, we are one of the biggest states for domestic violence. Up to 80 to 100 die a year by the hands of perpetrators. And so one of the things that we're here to do about Women Rise is to empower our women, to let them know that they are sheroes, that we are here sheroes, and that we have the power and the worth to be able to get that job training, that job readiness, to be able to walk out of that relationship, because a lot of times we stay because of money or the value. So what we've learned and what mama done and what grandmama stayed. And so we're here, this Women Rise, it's just about that self-empowerment piece. And it's not always women that's victims of domestic violence. There are men, and we have a big, big thing going on with our bisexuality environment, because there's a lot of violence that's going on between same sex. So it's an epidemic. And it's here to stay. And so Women Rise is just going to be all about is building self-worth, bringing on the healing, helping our women become self-dependent, independent, self-efficiency.
Sure.
It's the number one thing. So,
well,
I'm excited.
And what you bring up is an excellent point about respecting one another.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Just generally, just across the board, respect for one another. And that empowers us in and of itself. So that's an awesome, awesome conference coming up.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to it. I think as when you talk about, I'm a mama's boy too.
And, wow, that's okay.
I'm probably, we had a competition on who was the bigger mama's boy.
Okay.
But he's taught me something today actually that was very valuable about being a mama's boy. But I'm a mama's boy, and as a advisory board member for Our Seats Tomorrow, my job is to bring, as a film producer, I have access obviously to media and talent and that type of thing. So my job is to bring that aspect to it, because celebrity comes media, and to be able to, my mother, who I'm still talking to show up on this panel, as everyone knows, the inspiration behind Madea and that whole nine yards. So she will, we all know Madea character from the Tyler Perry show. So you already know she's a strong, strong woman, to say the least. So, you know, I'm looking at bringing her on a panel and things like that, because I do, I have so much respect for women because of my mother and what she sacrificed to raise four boys on her own. So, yes, this panel and what we're working on for that event is gigantic. And I want to touch upon Ebola for a second. I think that you said something very important. You said, we talked about two things there being fear, right? And fear comes from a lack of education thereof.
It
has nothing to do with the actual event. When Ebola came to Georgia, the number one thing on my Facebook and my Twitter accounts and things like that was, are they insane? What if it leaks out of the CDC or Emory and we all get sick? It had nothing to do with compassion, and it had nothing to do with how do we help. It had nothing to do with any of that. So my job is to try and get educate the public and say, listen, encourage you to take a step in a direction that I know you're afraid of. Take a mm-hmm. small step in that direction, and you're going to see that it's not going to hurt you. And again, mm-hmm. to galvanize all of these people to put together and resources to donate to our seas tomorrow so that we can get these things out to those communities. I mean, you're talking about Doctors Without Borders, who spoke with the executive office with the Obama administration and said, listen, and everyone's asking us, what do we need? And everyone assumes it's always money.
Right.
And it's like, no, we don't want money. We want supplies. Right. We want an extra pillow. We want extra beds. We want all of these things so that we can save these people's lives. Mm-hmm. Because a lot of people don't understand that Ebola, there's no cure for it.
That's right.
But mm-hmm. if you can get people to sustain life long enough to allow your immune system to rebuild, vitalize, you stand a chance of surviving. So, I mean, that is such an important cause right now. And again, it's not about the fact that it's on another continent, because it may be in your back door tomorrow, but it'll be on your front porch the next day if you don't pay attention.
Yeah.
And again, forget it being on your front porch. The fact that human suffering is just unfortunate, and it's such a violent, violent disease. It's such it's not one that it kills you very violently. Mm-hmm. And Dr. Gopi did a great job
wonderful,
educating great everyone at the panel about how bad it is. It was a tough picture to look at, but you had to look at it and understand that it is a violent and horrible disease. And just like we saved those two doctors, American doctors at Emory, we can apply the same techniques to save a lot of lives and give these people a better chance.
I wanted to add just a little bit to that on the Ebola front, and I want to come back to the women's rights. On the Ebola front, just to give you a little story, a synopsis of one of the reasons why we are such a major stakeholders on the Ebola front. Our CISTOMOR is a registered NGO in Liberia. We are established in Liberia as an NGO with the government, Minister of Foreign Affairs. And another thing is that our work is not Liberia, it's the region. They are lives, they are people.
Sure.
What we will do in Guinea, Sierra Leone, is what we'll do in Liberia. There are nurses, people on the front line. Mm-hmm. And another thing I want to bring to attention is that we're taking the front. I met with a very great friend of mine, John Schultz, who's in the church for me, Atlanta Berry's president. He said, Dazzy, as soon as you get this event up, I'll sign up to it. And the key thing is to build a hospital mm-hmm. in the region.
Okay.
Because it will be another virus to pop up. It will be something, as you know. Mm-hmm. So our siege tomorrow concerns much more the logistics in the area, putting a healthcare system that the people, suppose you can't make it to America, that means you have to die.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You know, and one thing I like about this country, they are very supportive, earthquake around the world, everybody is running. And that's the reason why I would tell people, I love this country. It's because there are great people in this country that will work for humanity. Another thing is, I want to talk about the women's rights, just to come back to the women's rights. There's another two piece I just don't want us to forget about. The other piece is job readiness, which is part of the package. We are doing this because I think, you know, we are in such a great recession where so many people are suffering and out of work. And the fourth piece part of that was the health awareness. We're doing another health awareness year. We want to encourage doctors in the metropolitan of Atlanta, please sign up for this program. We want to also encourage nurses. We want to encourage volunteer in the healthcare field. We want to encourage business that can donate towards this project, because we want to be able to touch a lot of people. We will be doing the health program that would look up to women's and children. They are young kids that need it.
Absolutely.
And we want to have reference basis from these health organization doctors that can refer some of these people that have no insurance, that they can get some attention. So like Commissioner Stan said in her letter, Mr. Dazia, we want to talk to you about the great work you're doing in the community. But hey, I love DeKalb County. That's where my mother said her, and that's all I know.
Mother again.
I noticed he's mentioned that several times.
I support him.
Right.
I support him.
Right. One more thing I wanted to bring to the attention of our audience, and then also make sure we touch upon, and that is your partnership with the city of Clarkston.
Yes.
Talk about that. We haven't talked about that
yet.
So let's talk about that piece before we run out of time.
One of the pieces is that the American dreams, a lot of times we come to the country, and I don't like the names refugees because we are all the same people. Mm-hmm. I knew I came to this country, whether I come here with a green card or not, we are all the same people. I don't like that word refugees. Mm-hmm. But I believe that we have brothers and sisters coming in from Cambodia, coming in from other part of the world, not just only Africa. And if for a lot of the audience who don't know, Clarkston is the second largest demographic of foreign people in the United States, second largest city that have the highest number of foreign people. Mm-hmm. And it's just not only African. You got people from Cambodia, all of these different nationality. It's a place that we, just like we work in DeKalb, and all of our program is not specific just for one group.
Sure.
Whatever program we're doing in Clarkston, the door is open to anyone. But we felt that focusing on that area, health awareness, English as a second language, job readiness, all of these things that can prepare and propel them into the 21st century, that they can realize the American dreams and be able to go out there without fear. Because when someone can speak English, first of all, he's afraid to open his mouth.
Sure.
He will be rejected. Mm-hmm. So as a person who coming from Liberia in 1985, we speak English, but I could speak English when I came, I was carrying an accent. And people would say, what?
Yeah.
Then
yeah.
I close my mouth because you feel now that
sure.
something is wrong.
Ostracized.
Right. And I've been through that. So I realized that from my own experience, I can also give some of that part back to the city of Clarkston. We had the opportunity to meet Mayor Ted Terry. He came to the church. We had another meeting, came to the board meeting. Mm-hmm. We talked. He told me some great initiative that we can do in the city of Clarkston. And then when we talked to the Atlanta Braves president, he was very happy of coming on board, helping our seas tomorrow, what we can do. But Clarkston needs the program.
Yes.
And let me say something to you. This English as a second language is just on the Clarkston. In our community, some people, when the English come and you want to go and get a job, you have to be able to communicate with people.
Sure, mm-hmm. sure, absolutely. Well, we have gotten so much information about what it is that you do. And I know that there's so much more that we couldn't possibly cover in the time that we have. So what I'd like for you to do is give our audience your website and some contact information as to how to follow up with you if they're wanting to volunteer, if they're in fact wanting to know more about this program with the city of Clarkston, and more.
Yes,
ma'am. If they want to find out about the event, all of that, how do they reach you?
Oh, you can reach our Seas Tomorrow. Direct number is 470-257-2600. 470-257-2600. You can also go to the website and you can donate by going to the donate button. Click on that. We have the bank information and we can also read that in a minute. Or you can go to www.OurSeedsTomorrow.org. You can visit the website. There are a lot of information on the website, or you can Google Our Seas Tomorrow. You have tons of our project and what we have been doing in the community. Deanne, can you go back with some of the bank information that we have up there to give out?
Sure. You can make donations to the SunTrust Bank, and I'm going to read the number so I don't. It's account number 10017801101010. And again, you can make donations straight to the bank at SunTrust and also on via the website. And I do want to also add, Dasia, that
yes,
we
yes,
do
ma'am.
Have the intent to try and raise $200,000.
Yes, yes. Absolutely.
Because to hark back to the conversation about the supplies and the food and the treatment centers, we need money to do that. So that's why we're actually asking for donations.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Well, we have had a wonderful time. Awesome, amazing guest, Dasia Fumba. The founder and the executive director of Our Seeds Tomorrow, and his great panel of guests and stakeholders right here on the Stan Watson Show. We'll be right back with more great guests if you'll stay tuned. We'll be right back. with the Stan Watson Show. I just want to give you a couple of great announcements. Stan would like to thank the community elected officials and PTAs who participated in the September On the Road to DeKalb County Community Cabinet Breakfast this past Saturday at the Stevenson High School. It was a great breakfast, and of course, we're looking forward to seeing you at the next one. And then he is also pleased to announce that he is hosting the annual Super 7 Sweep Stevenson Area Community Cleanup. It's going to be this Saturday, September the 13th, 2014. The starting point for the cleanup will be the Stevenson Middle School. It's 922 Stevenson Road, Stone Mountain, Georgia, 30087. And for more information, you just have to contact his office. It's 404-371-3681. And then the next day, I want you to join me in Douglasville at the Tributary Park. It's going to be called Jazz on the Green. So if you love jazz, it's free. Come out from 5 to 8 p.m. and you get to hear me, yours truly, Samantha Cardwell, and my band sing jazz. So we hope to see you there. And then also, if you want to call Stan's office and have your name placed on the email distribution list, you definitely need to do that. You know the number. It's 404-371-3681. And for more updates on what's happening with District 7 Community, you visit him at www.politicalstan.com. Of course, you want to like his Facebook page, Commissioner Stan Watson, and follow him on Twitter at Political Stan. Well, that's all of the great announcements, and now we have a great guest. We've got Kathy Irby Durant. She's a producer, director, and she is over Divine Communications. Welcome, Kathy.
Welcome.
Thank you.
We're so
much.
Glad to have you.
I'm happy to be here.
Yeah. Well, you know, of course, I was listening to everything that's going on. Do you have like some kind of book production? Tell us what all you're doing, because you're doing all kinds of stuff.
Well, actually, I'm the producer director of a movie called Going Out a Champion, the Coach Joe Ellis story.
Wow.
And it's the story of a coach who dreamed of winning a state basketball championship.
Okay.
He won that championship in 2005, and unfortunately, he died 8 weeks later of colon cancer.
Wow.
So it was his lifelong dream to win for his high school, and it happened, and then life, you know, took him home. His life ended. But the good thing about his story is the fact that he didn't lay down to cancer. Mm-hmm. He decided to live his last year coaching, and they won 27 plus games and finished strong. And he always said he wanted to go out a champion, and that's what he did.
So now, as a filmmaker or producer, you have to have, or I would think that you would have, a tie to the story. Do you have a personal tie to the story, or was it just told to you and you decided to make it live?
Well, actually, I'm doing the adaptation of a book, the book Going Out a Champion.
Okay.
And it turns out that the coach's wife, Doris M. Ellis, wrote the book Going Out a Champion. And she contacted me online and asked me would I consider turning her book into a film. So I said, well, let's see. I'm going to read the book, and I kind of read till the violin stop. I say, if it stops on the first page, then that's a wrap.
Good.
But I read the book and couldn't put it down. I read it all the way through. She's a great storyteller, and I decided, yes, what a great humanitarian story about this man who just wouldn't lay down. And the kids were just so inspired by him. He became a media child. The TV news, newspapers, ESPN, USA Today picked up the story, and it was a big story. So after that, I was fortunate enough to find Bea Bliss, who is the leading lady in this movie.
Okay.
She plays Doris Ellis.
Wow.
And Doris,
my guest co-host is in the movie.
And Dominique Wilkins of the Atlanta Hawks, formerly of the Hawks, is Coach Joe Ellis.
Wow.
And it was just amazing. We got Dominique, and then I saw Bea on Facebook, and she looked just like Doris Ellis. And now Doris and Joe have an amazing story. They met in high school. They both played basketball. They both shared the same last name, and they both wore the jersey number 24.
Wow.
So when we found Bia and she told me she played basketball too,
okay.
I was like, oh my God, this is incredible. Yeah, so it's just been so many stories like that surrounding this movie. And you know, I'm just, we're fortunate enough for me to be here today to talk about it. It's a great film. It's gonna be shot in Virginia.
Okay.
But the post-production will happen, and all of the post-production will happen in Atlanta, where I'm based.
Awesome.
So we're very, very excited, and we've been promoting like crazy. We just wrapped up our Indiegogo crowdfunding campaign.
Okay.
And it went pretty well, but
yeah.
We're a long ways from our goal. But the good thing about it is Facebook just rolled out the red carpet for it. Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, YouTube. We've just gotten a lot of coverage.
That's good. Well, and what really makes this thing sing is that Atlanta, it has become a mecca of where there's so much talent coming from this area. And and to see, because you're here in Atlanta as well.
Yes, I'm based here.
Awesome, awesome. Well, yeah. Why don't you tell them how they can find out more about it, how to support it, maybe a website where they can find out more information about it.
The movie is basically, it'll be shot in Virginia, and we're going to do the recreation of the final five games of Joe Ellis's life. Two of the games, the semifinal and the final, will be shot at VCU. And we're very excited to a crowd of about 8,000 people. So you can look me up, Kathy, C-A-T-H-Y, Durant, D-U-R-A-N-T, .com, www.kathydurant.com, and my website will lead you everywhere you need to go about this movie.
Awesome, awesome, awesome. Well, we have had awesome guests tonight on the Stan Watson Show, and we just had Kathy Durant here telling us about her great film, and we've even had our guest co-host to star in the film, and definitely we want you to go out and support. And we want you to always support the Stan Watson Show. We've had a wonderful time with you on this evening, and we'll see you next week right here on the Stan Watson Show.